Dear all, I hope you are learning the tutorial videos which I have been posting till now. Let us see where we are in the process of learning. So we had built the enterprise structure, we had defined the article types, and we had created the characteristics, values and merchandise categories. Then we created the articles. So we created many, we had seen many ways of creating the articles by manual transaction, by copying. Price catalogs we hadn't seen, we will see. Using the article monitor, defining the sales set, prepacks and additionals. Okay, so with this we came to the end of the basic master data. Excuse me. Now we had created the materials, we had created our organization. Now you have to move to the next step of what to sell at which store. For that we have to see the concept of assorting and listing, assortment and listing. Okay. What is an assortment? Assortment, according to the general English, is a miscellaneous collection of things. Here when I say assortment in SAP, it's also meaning the same thing. It's about the collection of articles that can be handled in a particular store. When I say handle, that can be bought and distributed in a particular store. So you have to tell the store that these are all the materials you can place order for and you can raise sales order for. Okay. So once the process of assortment is executed, it results in the list of materials for the store, which we call as listing conditions. There are many ways of creating the listing conditions and we will see them. It is still in the master data. So logistics, retailing, master data, assortment and listings. Okay. So before we go into the transactions related to assortment, we will see the what assortment means. Okay. So basically assortment is nothing but a bag which is going to accommodate the list of materials that can be bought and sold in a particular store. Okay. So whenever you are creating a store, the system automatically creates a local assortment that is associated with that store alone. Okay. There are two types of assortment. So one is the general assortment and one is the local assortment. So local assortment is one which is automatically created by the system whenever you create a site master. Okay. So for example, we have created a site called W100. There is a assortment by the same name that has been created, and the system says like you will be able to do only limited processing. This data, the basic data tab, you will not be able to edit. Only thing you can be able to edit is the merchandise categories, and you will not be able to add any more user. Okay. So which means this local assortment is specific only to that particular site. So it is a store assortment category. Okay. So whenever you create a site, you give WB02. Whenever you create a site, you give the listing procedure there. You remember in the listing tab we used to maintain. Okay. So this listing procedure is adopted in the local assortment. Okay. So this is the local assortment. Generic assortment is generic assortment is something which we define. So we can group a set of stores which are similar in the characteristics, are similar in the category, and put them in a general assortment, and you assign the materials to that. Okay, so if I had, let me show you one W, yes, store type one. In this I have defined, I had put together the stores that have a similar nature, and you could see the assignment category is C. It is the customer assignment category. And the basic data is editable. Here I can give my own parameters. So what are the things I'll be able to. Okay, so this is the general general assortment. So when you are defining the system as a retail system, you have to define whether you can have general assortment and local assortment. In other way, you have to tell the system whether the multiple assignments are possible, which means whether a customer or a site can be allowed to have a local assortment and assigned to multiple general assortment. Okay, so you have to make this decision before you start configuring or using your system. In the general parameters of IS Retail, you have to, this is where multiple assignment is active. You have to define whether you can have the local assortments as well as the, whether several plants can be assigned to assortment C. If not, there is 1:1 ratio between the plant and assortment. Okay, so once you had marked it as multiple assignment is active and you have created few local assortments, after that you decide that no, let me go with the site specific local assortment only, I don't want generic assortment, you would not be able to make any changes. Let us see what happens. So it is resetting the functionality to 1:1 assignment is not permitted. You have to make your decision first before configuring the system itself as a IS Retail system. Then only you have to start creating the assortments accordingly. Okay, so now we had seen what an assortment is, what are the types of assortment, that is the local assortment and general assortment, and what is the difference between them from configuration perspective, and we had seen where that key for a multiple assortment and local single assortment is made. Okay, so in general, whenever you are creating an assortment, okay, so there are many ways of assigning the materials to an assortment. Okay, so one is create assortment modules. And assign materials to assortment modules, module or modules. Okay, it's not necessary that it has to be a plural one. The next step, assign the module or modules to the assortment or assortments. Okay, here what you can do is, like, you can create one set of assortment module and you can assign them to the required assortment. For example, let us say that I have one module which is containing the articles of toothpaste. Okay, I can put this assortment, that is assignment module, I can put this paste material in the cosmetic assortment, or I can put them in the health assortment. Okay, so wherever it is possible, I'll be able to assign it, and I'll be able to assign it to multiple assortment at the same time. Okay, so whenever you had assigned the same assortment to multiple, you had assigned the same material to same assortment by means of multiple modules, system will look first, it will create the listing conditions with the first available combination. Then it will say like, no, it is duplicated, the material is already listed in the so and so assortment, then it will not create the listing for the subsequent combinations. Okay, so this is one way of doing that. Okay, and the other way of doing that is letting the system to create automatic modules, assortment modules according to the business functionality. For example, your promotional modules, rack jobber modules. So in these scenarios, the system will automatically create the assortment modules automatically. You need not create them manually. Whenever the system is creating assortment, it will create with the validity date based on the promotions. Okay. And third one is by using the concept of layouts. Layout is also very similar to assortment module. So here what we do, you create layout module, you put the materials into the layout module. So create layout modules and assign materials. Assign layout modules to layout. Assign layout to assortments. So instead of creating an assortment module and assigning the materials, you are creating layout modules and assign the materials, and you are assigning those material, that layout modules, to the layout, and you are linking the layout to the assortment. In this way, a link between the materials and the assortment is made. Okay, so these are all the multiple ways of creating the assortment. And once an assortment is done successfully, executed successfully, the system updates the tables WLK1, WLK2 and WLK3. Okay. Only when these table entries are created, your assortment is executed successfully. Okay. So that's the basic introduction of assortment. We will see the multiple ways of creating and executing the assortment to generate the listing conditions in the subsequent videos. Have a good day. If you had liked this video, please like it, share it with your friends, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Have a good day.